Very good morning to you all. Welcome back to Simplify Cancer. This week, we'll have a question and answer session for the common questions which I received in the past 3 weeks, predominantly of breast cancer. So the first question which I received was, do men also develop breast cancer? Surprisingly, the answer is yes. Men also have breast tissue, just like women, but the quantity of estrogen and progesterone is not the same, and hence the development of breast tissue does not take place. It is quite a rare cancer and accounts to only approximately 1% of all breast cancers. The exact reason why men develop breast cancer is not known, but a few syndromes like Klinefelter syndrome and BRCA2 mutations have been found where there is a chance of developing breast and prostate cancers. The investigations, staging, and the treatment of breast cancer for both men and women remain same, and the outcomes are also quite similar. The next common question I received was, does everyone require a genetic testing, or why don't we do genetic testing for all females who develop breast cancer? It is neither ideal nor practical to do such genetic testing for everyone. There have been specific guidelines which have been put in place, like a woman with a family history of breast cancer, women below the age of 40 years who develop breast cancer, women with breast cancer in both breasts, and women with breast and ovarian cancer. These are some common situations wherein a genetic counseling and a genetic testing is advised. And in case a mutation is identified in these women, further testing can be done in their family, either their siblings or their children. BRCA1 and BRCA2 are the most common mutations in breast cancer. That doesn't mean that all patients will have these mutations. So it does not make practical sense to do these mutations for everyone. The other implication remains that even if your genetic test is negative, there is a chance that you might develop breast cancer. That is, you will be categorized from a high risk to an average risk group. The next common question which I received is, are all these treatments for breast cancer always successful? One thing we need to understand about treatment for any cancer, and definitely in breast cancer, is success is not a single point solution. Success is always phased. So the level one of success would be identifying the cancer early. The next level of success would be completing a proper treatment. Then the third level of success would be being on follow-up. And the final level of success would be after 5 years when there is no more disease and you are cancer-free. The first two levels of success, that is identifying the disease early and getting a proper treatment, are what are in our hands. Beyond that, whether the disease recurs or not is based on two factors. One is the immunity of the patient, other is the biology of the disease. These are factors which are not in our control, so we keep the patient on regular follow-up and try to identify the disease early if it comes. All our treatments are aimed at success, and the best we can do is give the best treatment possible and hope for the best. And definitely we are seeing very good results with all these treatments. The last question for today's session is a very common fear which I see in almost most of my patients. They ask me, will the chemotherapy which I receive result in hair loss? We need to understand that in today's time, the treatment, especially supportive therapy for chemotherapy, has advanced in leaps and bounds. The common side effects like nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea, generalized weakness, these have been to a good extent reduced with the supportive therapy. Yes, hair loss still continues to occur, but after completion of chemotherapy, usually within 3 to 6 months, most of you will develop your hair back and you will look as beautiful as before and as worthy as ever. Thank you for watching this video. See you next week with a new topic. Take care.